John, why don't you launch us into the substance?
Okay. Give a brief summary of my president's report here. Just hit some of the highlights. As of 60 days into the season, we'd hauled 15,911 passengers. Year to date, we were about 4% behind the same place we were last year. But a little explanation is in order there. Last year was the year that Durango had all the problems and was not running. So we are, to get a better view of what where the railroad is, I'm going back and looking at comparison to 2017, and we were 14.5% ahead of where we were in 2017. By comparison, at the moment, or as of about a week or two ago, Durango was about even with where they had been in 17. So there is still some hangover effect for them at this point, and we're, I believe, in fairly decent shape. They had had a 41-day shutdown that took out all of June for them and part of July, and then we are now in the spot where they'd gone through the floods and they were operating again, but only from Rockwood to Silverton. So there will still be some effect to be seen from the variation that happened in 2018. Our bookings, looking forward toward the end of our season, as of the 17th, we're about 1,350 bookings ahead of where we were in 2018, which is positive news. So the bookings were up about 3.5%. Revenue were up about 4.7%. Assuming that we end up with these numbers holding up, we will be in line with our 10-year plan to reach self-sustainability. So we're encouraged by that. The special trains are doing well. The geology train sold out. Thank you very much for all your help on that, Rich. With the arrival of the new tables at Osier, we were able to free up some tables, which we have moved to Cumbres, and Stephen has said he can feed more people and do it efficiently at Cumbres, and so we bumped the numbers. We used to cut off for the special trains that went to Cumbres at 160. We bumped that up to 200 for the 4th of July. Did a good job, and I'd like to take a moment to commend Billy for the amazing fireworks display. But we were able to get 200 people fed and back down in time to start the 4th of July fireworks display. We have bumped up the capacity for the Chris Collins concert, which is tonight, to 200, and that is essentially sold out now. And we're seeing good response now to the wildflower excursion and to the speakeasy train. We're coming up now on the mariachi train as well. We have finished a new commercial, which will start airing in Albuquerque this next week and in the Colorado Springs market this next week, as well as in the visitor centers. Of course, we won the Best Train Ride in America for the second time that contest ran, and we have won it both times. And that a railroad that hauled, let's call it 43,000 people, came in first compared to railroads that hauled over 400,000 people is a testament not only to the wonderful job that we do as a railroad and how much our fans love us, but also to the friends of the Cumbres and Toltec who are now skilled at knowing how to stuff the ballot box. And we appreciate it. We appreciate it. When I first got on as president of the railroad, one of the commissioners said, you know, the thing you need to do is give yourself an award and then talk about it. Well, this has been quite serendipitous because we didn't create the award, but we've won it twice and can talk about it, and that helps on our marketing program. The group here in Antonito has finally gotten the 524 in service.